it a few seconds here to start. Well, hello there. God bless you this evening, this afternoon, wherever you're at today. I hope God will speak to your hearts today through all the wonderful singers here at Queen City. I think God has an amazing opportunity for everyone here as we continue to spread the gospel of Jesus Christ wherever we are. Because so many times we run into problems where we don't realize what's happening in our lives. Maybe God just trying to tug at us and tell us that it's going to be all right and that he has control. So we got a little few selections here for you for this next hour. We're going to start with Miranda on a song. If you're not familiar with this instrument is, of course, I'm hoping I'm pointing the right way. I'm pointing to my right, which is your left probably. You want to tell them what that is? Because a lot of people don't know what that is.
This is an auto harp.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really unique, and it really kind of just kind of gives a whole other take on some when you play it on songs you may know that you, and when you hear it playing on a harp, it's like wow, it's like a totally different song. And so we're gonna start with an old hymn called Joy Unspeakable.
Mm-hmm. Enjoy this nice little rendition there. That's a pretty good old gospel hymn out there, Joy Unspeakable. Next, we're going to kind of bring it up back to the 90s with a little 90s sonic flood thing going on here called In the Secret, I Want to Know You. All right.
Touch you.
I just took that song to a whole different place.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty cool. So,
you want to talk about what we did last night?
Oh, what did we do last night? So, that's a good question. I don't know about you, but I ate dinner. No. What we did last night? Last night was something that I think Miranda should talk about because it's more involving on her end than mine because it's been 10 years since she's been able to do something. So, I'm going to hand it back to you to talk about that.
So last night we had the opportunity to go to church together, which we've gone to a church service together. But the thing that was different was we actually got to play music at a church, a little church in Ross County, Ohio, and we had not performed together in person in a church in 10, almost 11 years because where I've been so sick with Crohn's disease. So it was really powerful to be able to just go and play a few little songs. And I told Jeremy, I said, honestly, the best part, it wasn't even about getting to sing. It was just about being able to go to church and be in the presence of the Holy Spirit, fellowship with other people, and see people go to the altar and their lives being changed and people shouting because they got blessed. That hearing a great sermon, that means more to me than being able, getting up and singing a few songs sometimes. Just
so that puts it in perspective because she's not even 40 yet and it's been 10 years since she's been able to perform at a physical church. I mean, doing this online is a lot different than trying to get her ready to go and leave the house and deal with the drive and then setting up and then doing this here. Everything's already set up. She's just got to, clean up, get dressed, and sit down. And that's what, half an hour. Although, just to perform this 5 to 6, we've been working on this stuff since about like 3:30 today. So then she'd be ready and make final decisions if I had to do this alone like last time or not. And
but,
something
God,
still could happen.
But God is just... He's amazing, and we thank him for, not being done with me yet and still having things for me to do. And through people's prayers, that was really what did it. I mean, through people, the pastor of the church praying, saying he really begged God to allow, to stop this disease so I could come and be at his church. And they really, just a little mission church on the country, but I'll tell you, they are spirit-filled people, and they love to serve the Lord. So, this is how deep the Father's love for us.
How deep the Father's love for us. Hey.
So I don't know about you. When's the last time you went 10 years without something? Or, you know, many of us who grew up poor, we went 20, 30 plus years without different things. I know one of the big milestones of my life was how long it took for me to get a cassette tape, VCR. I'm like, here I am in the late 90s and getting a, you know, VCR, and that came out in the 80s. I never had my own car until I was 24. I have other friends who said, well, they didn't have brand new clothes until they were 40. But what's something that's gone through your life that you thought you should have already had but haven't yet? And it's like a barrier in your mind that maybe you don't think about it, or maybe you do. But then God shows up in the midst of what you have or you don't have, and He works with what you got. And it confuses the world a lot of times. And that's what God loves to do many times. He loves to show up when you least expect it. And He transforms your life. And sets you free. You're the Lord. Reaches to the heavens. Stretches to the sky. Yeah. Your righteousness is like a mighty mountain. Yeah. Your justice flows like the ocean high. Times we wonder, what does God have planned for us? And the plans that He has for us go beyond anything we can imagine, no matter what we have or we don't have.
We're going to go back and we're going to do another old hymn for you, and hope you enjoy it. And this is At Calvary. Let me know when you're ready.
I'm ready.
Years of bitterness and pride, carrying on my Lord's truth.
going to do an old Amy Grant song for you. And I have never heard anybody play this on the auto harp before. And it's typically a, you know, either a piano song. But when I played it on the auto harp, I was like, wow, it just completely changed. It seemed like it just completely changed the song. And it is so beautiful. And most of you who listen to Amy Grant will know this one. This is El Shaddai.
Shift change.
Jeremy right. always has it easier than me.
I have it easier. All I got to do is...
He just normally sticks to just... He just plays one instrument.
What we're going to probably do in the future is... I'll have some of the other instruments. We're looking at a clarinet, saxophone, guitar, medley.
Yeah.
But we'll eventually do. And that means I'll be the one shifting out and she'll be like on one instrument. So we'll change it up next time. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
This next song, it's one that my grandfather especially liked that I sang, and he passed away in January, and so this one's for you, Pa. This is The Only Real Peace.
Oh,
hang off my head.
Oh, I'm sorry.
But you just keep going.
Yep.
That's why I didn't do that ending I typically do.
Well, that was quick. So.
And he was probably like, why is she just
what's
quitting?
Going on here? Well, you never know.
My microphone was sliding backwards off my head. Okay.
Well, I got to tell you, folks, it's been a journey, hasn't it, so far? We're at the halfway point, and
we better talk a little more.
Yeah. So here's the thing. I know that there's so many times, and like the transition of this song is the reason why we're stopping to pause for a moment to talk. And I've sang this here before, and I've sang it elsewhere. Like, we just came off a 60-hour conference with almost 100 nations involved, and all the nations were talking about to be sent out amongst their own nations and other nations. And in the situation that we're in with this virus and these political climates and everything else in between that's going on, Jesus Christ is the only hope for all these situations. He's the only cure for your problems, to solve your political problems, your disputes, and everything else. He can set you free from the things that have been in your life that have held you back. And this song talks about God healing your land. But it also talks about, is that the cry of your heart? And today, sadly, we're faced with so many things. A lot of people aren't seeing God in the midst of the circumstances that happen. So we have to ask the question, what are we going to do? Where are we going to let God move? How is he going to operate in what we're doing today? This is You Said. Let this be dedicated to everyone that's here at Queen City, everyone that is involved in ministry. Let it be the cry of our hearts today to want to see the kingdom of God come.
Lift up your eyes, the harvest is here, the kingdom is near.
my first time I ever played that song on the mandolin. So.
Maybe this time tonight she won't be so blessed she wants to sing her own
verse.
Yeah,
this next song, when we were playing this song last night at church, people were getting blessed, and I just closed my eyes, I started playing, and the next time I looked down to just play like the next play the chorus or whatever, I started I looked at the wrong part of a section of the page, and I started playing the wrong part of the music. And it went bad, but I made the comment. I said, I'm pretty sure that if you play the right section of the song when you're supposed to, it'll sound a lot better than what I just did.
Wow.
And everybody just laughed. But you know, the thing is, no matter how professional people think you are, so we're still human. I'll tell you a story. Every time I ever saw Casting Crowns, a concert, the lead singer, he has dyslexia. And every single time that I saw him, just this one song, he would mix up the first verse with the second verse. And he would, and they'd have to restart the song. He says, I did it again. And that seems to be what I do with this song for some reason, too. But it goes to show you we're all human. No matter how good a musician, you still are human, and you're still going to have human error at times. But praise the Lord anyway. You know what? And instead of doing the ugly cry, you know, when people get blessed, they do ugly crying. I did the, I just lost my mind, and I forgot how to play my instrument.
Aye, sir.
All right, let's try this. Hopefully, she can do this. Let's see what happens. If not, I'll make something up. I don't know.
Oh, goodness. This is enough. All of you is more than
Sometimes you don't know. Sometimes you try and figure it out, and you get lost. Now, I have to say that this evening, throughout all of the wonderful Queen City Music Promotions, guests, wonderful singers, regulars, that God is using this platform to spread the gospel all over the place. And I want you to know that we do this, us and everyone else, we do this because we want to spread the gospel. We want to let you hear what Jesus has done in our lives. There are many others that talk about what God does in our lives. And I hope that you can hear that message today. This is one of those songs like that.
When the night comes and you're all alone, when there's trouble staring in your soul, if your love is falling apart, just hold on for the morning, the break dawn. Come and leave. There's a promise of a burden light. Come and lay your burden down to the place where freedom is found. At the feet of Jesus. Come and when we see Him face to face, all of our worries will surely fade away. In the presence of His glorious light, we'll sing hallelujah to the One who gave us life. Come and pay. Come and lay your burden down. Come and lay your burden down to the place where freedom is found. At the feet of Jesus. Come and lay. Come and lay your burden down. Come and lay your burdens down.
We hope today that God has called you to lay your burdens down. Whatever it is. Worrying about this virus. Worrying about a job. Worrying about your friends. Worrying about your family. What is it in your life right now that you could probably say to me and everyone else, yeah, I have a burden. I have a medical bill burden. I have a health issue burden. I have a school burden. Will you do my homework for me, Jeremy? No, I might not do your homework for you, but what is it in your life right now that where you'd have to say, I need to lay my burden down? You need to say, Jesus, I can't do this on my own. I have people in my life, but people in my life can't, they're not always going to know what's going on, and I don't know how to talk about it. I don't know what to do. I don't know how to resolve the issues in my life. And then God comes, and what happens? When you let Jesus Christ in your life, He can grab a hold of you in such a way and hold tight in your life when it doesn't make any sense. When you think the mountains and valleys called your life are too big and too impossible, and that you don't have enough faith to move on. You don't have enough strength. You can't say, "I'll ask for the nation." You can't, you know God is great. You know that you love Him, and you know His joy is unspeakable, and you know the Father's love is deep. And you know that His only real peace can carry you through because He is enough. And that He shed His blood on Calvary. But still, we as humans have this flaw. This flaw that causes us to be separate. This flesh, our tongue, our mind, our heart, the things that we do. Or maybe it's not us that's the problem. Maybe it's not the way you're thinking. Maybe there literally is an obstacle in your way. You don't have the money. You don't have the time. You don't have the skills. You don't have the people in your life. Maybe there's something holding you back. And you need God to come in these moments to set you free from these situations. God can do this if you let Him. If you just allow Him to set you free. You have any thoughts on this, Miranda, before we get to our last song?
No, I'm just always thankful for the opportunity to play music and share the message God's given us and use our talents to glorify Him.
Because you never know when something might change. A car accident, your health, your job. Miranda went 10 years without playing in a church. Now think about that. Most of y'all watch church and you see many pastors and ministers and things. She went 10 years without being able to go. She went this Sunday.
Well, I went to church, but not. I wasn't.
But not able to play. She was able to go, but she couldn't play. She wasn't. Not because she wasn't asked to play, but she asked multiple times. She's gone, but she wasn't well enough. Life is a gift. Let's hold on to this today. This song is "Hold Me, Jesus."
Sometimes my life don't just make no sense at all. If the mountains look so big and my faith just seems so small, so hold me, Jesus, 'cause I'm shaking like a leaf. You have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Prince of Peace? Wake up in the night and I feel the dark. So hot inside my soul, I swear there must be blisters on my heart. So hold me, Jesus, 'cause I'm shaking like a leaf. You have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Surrender don't come naturally. I'd rather fight you for something I don't really want than take what you give that I need. And I beat my head against so many walls. Now I'm falling down, I'm falling on my knees. And the Salvation Army band is playing this hymn. Oh, boundless salvation, deep ocean of love, I am sailing on an ocean wide and deep. I am trusting in the pilot, thy waters come over me. And you have been King of my glory. Won't you be my Prince of Peace?
I hope many times that we come into these moments that God will set you free from these things, from the mountains and valleys called your life. Because if you don't, what happens if you don't let God move? I'll tell you what happens. You get tossed through the waves of your life, and they don't make much any sense at all. And you start falling apart because you don't have Christ as the anchor into your life. Today. Let him set you free from the cares and worries of this world, because God cares for you. Jesus loves you today. I want you to understand that no matter what you've gone through. I have been homeless. I have gone through domestic violence. Brenda's gone through domestic violence. I've had people try to set me on fire, stab me, ridicule me, destroy everything I've had in my life. I've lost everything. I had people stalk me to try and kill me. She had people stalk her. And we are still here by the power of Jesus Christ. If Christ can set us free from these things and these moments that come, he can take care of you no matter what. You need to remember that today, that God wants to take care of you, that he loves you in spite of the storms of your life. God bless you, and we'll see you soon.